everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Tiffany. I like to do new weekly videos here on my channel, so hopefully you'll come back and see next week's one. But as you can see by the title, we are going to be talking about the new Amika hair blow dryer brush. So this new blow dryer brush from Amika retails for $100. I got mine off of Sephora's website. So what this is a two-in-one tool that combines a round brush and a blow dryer to easily and quickly create a smooth, shiny, and bouncy blowout using negative ion technology. For me, my hairstyle is more, or hair type is more on the thin side and straight, definitely extremely straight. Naturally, when I dry my hair, it just falls and it has pretty much no volume whatsoever. So the blow dryer brush came in this box. So you just flip up this bottom flap, and then inside it comes with the brush itself, which is this one right here, and then also comes with the instruction booklets and all that normal stuff. So here is the blow dryer brush, and it comes with three different settings. So first it has your off setting, then it has the fan to help cool and set your style in place, and then it has the one speed and two speed. So that one determines how much more heat you want to apply to your hair. And in order to change it to those settings, you just need to twist this knob in the middle. So it'll indicate which setting you're on by the clicks. I noticed with this too is that for the off and the high heat setting, it doesn't click all the way over the light like the other two do, so just keep that in mind. But yeah, I like the swivel cord at the bottom just so that when you're switching arm to arm, it's not as much of a hassle. The fan that sucks up all the air comes from the bottom, which then disperses at the top where you have your bristles. So you have your long bristles to help detangle, and then your shorter bristles for shine. Fortunately with mine, when I took mine out of the package, I did notice some of the bristles at the bottom were bent. I'm trying to like bend it back, and I tried to bend it back when I first got it too, but unfortunately it's kind of stuck like that. So I don't know if it's just me or if you get one and you see yours like that too. Maybe it's just because of how they put it in the packaging, but it's a little upsetting that it came to me already bent. Also, the cord on this is a 9-foot cord, so you do have a lot of distance from you to the outlet, so you can try to place yourself in front of a mirror that might not be in front of an outlet. So I like the fact that it is a long cord and does come with the Velcro to keep it all nice and in place. So when I was blow drying my hair, I did section it off into two sections in the middle. So on the left side of my head, I did not put any product in it. I just wanted to see how it worked, just using the brush on its own to see how much shine I could get, how much bounce I could get, and just to see how it would just react with just my hair alone. And on the right side, I decided to go in with one of their other products from Amika, and it is their Supernova Blonde Violet Moisture and Shine Cream. So this is supposed to help create more shine in your hair. You put it on damp hair. I just wanted to use this product since it is in their own same product line and see what it would offer if I use it in conjunction with the brush. So for me, I wouldn't say I'm at all good at hair. I can't even blow dry my hair normally with a normal round brush or do that whole blowout. I just have not mastered that skill yet to use both the blow dryer and the brush at the same time. So a tool like this is really appealing to me. I know I tried the Revlon one, and a lot of people love that one as well, and you can't go wrong with a product like that. Probably half the price of this one actually. And I tried that one before. I really like it too. It's the ease of use is there. So I want to try this one from Amika and see how a $100 brush compares to a $50 Revlon brush. So after detangling both sides of my hair and putting on the Amika cream on the right side, I timed how long it would take me to blow dry my entire head. And it took me about 26 minutes or so to blow dry it completely. I did have my hair up in my towel when I was getting ready putting on my makeup for maybe about 15 minutes or so, so it was drying a little bit there, but it didn't feel like it took that long of a time to blow dry it. I mean, getting the technique down first is the hardest part, and then seeing how long it would take to actually dry. I'm really happy with the outcome of this tool. I feel like it made my hair feel really smooth. Even the left side that didn't have any product in it feels really nice, and it looks really straight. I don't notice a lot of volume, but I, at the same time, again, am not a pro at this. I probably wasn't even doing it right to even get a lot of volume. Typically, when I blow dry my hair, I do it upside down, and then that gives me a lot more volume, which I didn't do today, so don't mind that fact. But besides that, for the claims of making my hair shinier, I feel like it did add some shine. It got rid of some of the frizz. Do I feel like it could be shinier? Yes, but I really like how it performed anyway. I use it on the high heat setting. I just want to see how fast it could blow dry my hair on that setting. But what do you guys think based off of what you saw today? Do you like the right side? Do you like the left? Do they both look bad? I don't know. You can be the judge. But I actually really like how it came out. Overall, I say I like this product. I like the idea behind it. It swivel cord, the long 9-foot range from it, and its ease of use. It's light, it's big. I like the big barrel on it, which helps to dry your hair faster, especially now I have grown out my hair. It is pretty long. It helps with drying it a little bit quicker. So I like that. I like how the bristles made my hair shinier and more frizz-free. Haven't tried it on the lower setting or the fan setting to set. I've only tried it on the high, but I also feel like I need to give it more of a chance just so that I can master trying to do a full blowout and get more volume up at the crown. I know I need to work more on that, but overall I like this product. I say if you're trying to save money, I definitely would go with the Revlon one just because it is half the price. But if you already have that one or into trying a new one, I definitely recommend Amika. Alright guys, that is it for today's video. I hope you guys liked it and found it informative and will help you in your buying decision. Please feel free to subscribe and follow me on Instagram. But until next time, cheers for now. Bye!